After 3 days of intensive engagement with the Operation Wealth Creation National Coordinator, leaders including RDCs, MPs and COWs of all the districts in the sub-regions of Lango, West Nile and Acholi have collectively agreed to improve the mindset of the wananchi in their localities.
Leaders of the North today, we repent that we have all sinned. We have misled the community. We have not done what we're supposed to do. We have been the politicking. But now as we live here, let's go and talk economic transformation.
We need to go back and engage our people. We need to even do more than what we've been doing, because the guidance we've got here is that our people need a lot of mindset change. Much as we've been trying to do that, we discovered in this meeting that we are not doing even more.
So the other issues discussed include the presidential order on charcoal business, the Balalo cattle keepers and cattle rustling that is currently affecting the sub-regions of Lango, Teso, Karamoja and Acholi.
I'd like to say that I need more discussion on the presidential executive order about cattle rustling, and then this issue of what? This issue of recruitment. That's where I was concentrating. When we had, I had to ask some question about that. But still, I'll go and inform the people and share with them on what we are going to do, what we have got from here while we prepare. But still, I need to also share with Saleh.
The meeting is an initiative of the OWC to awaken these leaders to lead their people out of poverty through productive farming using the abundant arable land.
What I want to do is to thank General, our Chief Coordinator, for having listened to me when I asked him to call you people.
The leaders, in turn, have committed to change their approach in engaging their people in production.
The common saying that too many rats don't make a hole. The number that was convened here was big, that could not exhaustively discuss and come up with concrete recommendations to inform policy making. We have agreed and come up with a working committee composed of technical team, composed of elected members, chairman five, and members of parliament in the sub-region, and composed of the RDCs. That should sit in the next 1 month. For now, they are going back to their respective locations and places of work to build synergies and statistics. That should help.
However, the RDC Lamo district is calling for strengthened deployment of security officers along the border, especially along the Uganda-South Sudan borderline.
We cannot have an overall production in these four sub-counties because of continuous attack of the South Sudanese. And what is important now is for us first to join hand and restore security in the area where people are sure of production. Because for now, we have tried to put new detaches in these areas. But at the same time, we are having collaborators and also our people from South Sudan who are now following our people with ox plow in the garden.
While the Acholi Parliamentary Group Chairperson Anthony Akol is calling for the revival of the cooperatives and to model the PDM in the strong existing groups.
Make it easy. You tell people to form groups. You don't work with the existing group. Who knows? They know each other. The cohesion between them. You are not putting in place that. If you bring people for the purpose of getting money for a yoga, they have not been working together. After getting the money, they separate.
General Salim Saleh received a thunderous applause for his continued fight against poverty in Uganda.
The common saying that too many rats don't make a hole. The number that was convened here.
The national coordinator of the Operation Wealth Creation then tasked these leaders to form working groups within themselves and stay committed to deliver their people from the clutches of poverty.
Up to now. So there is a protest that they are cooperating for people.
The Operation Wealth Creation was launched by President Yoweri Tibuhaburwa Kaguta Museveni in July 2013 as an intervention to efficiently facilitate national socio-economic transformation, with a focus on raising household incomes and wealth creation by transforming subsistence farmers into commercial farmers. This is in order to end poverty throughout Uganda. I am Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Gulu City.